Warning, these web clips feature stunts performed either by professionals or under the supervision of professionals. MTV and the producers must insist that no one attempt to reenact any stunt or activity performed on the site.
The following presentation is rated TVMA.
From Halifax, Nova Scotia, I'm Brian Hager here alongside my broadcast colleague, the DC People's Champ, but AMAC isn't here. You wonder why he's not here? He's in the rain. He's our very special guest coming up in just a few short moments.
Yeah, we're in Canada, eh? And Eddie's going to talk.
Last month at Supernova, six men put their bodies, their careers, and their lives on the line for the right to call themselves the CAW Champions League World Heavyweight Champion. And after a grueling 40-minute battle, one man stood tall and survived. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the CCL Heavyweight Champion of the World, he is Boston Strong, Gregory Black!
And here he comes, Tim. CCL World Heavyweight Champion, Boston Strong, Gregory Black. You were there with me for that amazing event out in Minnesota. He outlasted five other of the greatest professional athletes in the world to retain that CCL championship inside the Elimination Chamber. What an event it was.
I've said it after that match is over there. Gregory Black may have just cemented his legacy as the greatest CCL World Heavyweight Champion of all time. The challenges that he faced throughout the summer and then last month at Supernova show that he is worthy to hold that championship, the CEO championship that's on his way to the CWF World title as well. He's a double world champion.
Absolutely. And we're going to hear him talk.
Greg, you know how I feel about you on a personal level, or should I say, how I felt about you on a personal level. When you're a W, you walk down the CAW Champions League, presumably never to return. 2 months later, you return with a new contract and you won the Money in the Bank Royal Rumble match. and then an uprising. Just 9 minutes and 27 seconds after the Great D won the World Heavyweight title, you use your money in the bank to win, some would say steal, the world title. But I give you credit. Since then, you've been a fighting champion. At Future Shock, Hollywood Montour laid out a challenge. 3-man gauntlet match with 3 different rule sets. And you won. At Fanarchy, I laid out a challenge. An Elimination Chamber match against TRT and 4 other men voted by the fans. And based on the career-making decision on Adrenaline last month before that match, you decided not to give up your world title. You decided to stand and fight. And then you went in that chamber, not knowing that night who else was going to be in there with you. It didn't matter. You stood tall, and after 40 minutes of hell, you still hold the World Heavyweight title. I don't know if you've earned these fans' respect or not. That's up to them. Some haven't forgiven you for what you did last year, and I can totally understand that. But I wanted to tell you to your face that you're in my respect. Prayer.
They showed mutual respect between these two.
Yeah, big respect, like you mentioned. Frank walked out of here like back last this time last year. And next thing you know, he comes back and he's now the world champion.
Thank you very much for those kind words. And I have to say to you this. You are without a doubt one of the best damn commentators in all of CAW. Now, as far as I go, I've been trying my hardest to turn down my wicked ways and try to become loved again. Because this CCL World Heavyweight Championship isn't about me. It's about the people that came here to see the CCL World Heavyweight Champion. And that has been me. So I plan on being the World Heavyweight Champion. And I plan on changing things like I have been, like I wanted to, like I'm going to. And that's all I can say about that right now.
Excuse me. Mr. Black. Mr. Black.
I'm about
a buzz kill. There is, there comes the boss, Xavier Mitchell.
Back, retain the world title, and now he's got this guy coming on. Crowd here in Canada giving him a little air service.
Exactly. Thank you, Edward. I'll take it from here. Thank you. Mr. Black, I just wanted to congratulate you for retaining the CCL World Heavyweight Championship at Supernova. Now, look, I know you and I aren't on the same page, but obviously, but I'm sure with a little bit more time and a bit of mutual cooperation, we can make this experiment work.
They're making their lead spell. Make this work? Are you kidding me? Make this work? Hello? Think, McFly. Think. I'm not going to be your corporate champion, okay? If there's any person that I'm going to be a champion to, it's the people. The people that whether they hated me or they loved me, they still wanted to see me. They really cared about me. Whether they didn't or they did, they were there. They're always there. You just showed up out of the woodwork one day and decided that you were going to be a corporate manager. But to be honest with you, you're nothing more than a stupid little rat in a bullshit suit with a bullshit mind.
You know,
you're right. This can't work. This is never going to work. I see you with that world title belt, a belt you commissioned without our permission, after sending the old title back in ruin. I see you with that belt, and it makes me sick. It makes me sick that someone like you holds that world championship. Do you remember when you won the world title, what you said in the first adrenaline after you won it? Why don't we roll the footage in the truck and just refresh your memory quite a bit?
Fans of CCL, it's about time that each and every one of you bowed before me, because I am your new CCL World Heavyweight Champion.
Fuck you, man.
Unlike the past, where there were only five contenders for the world title, I am opening the floodgates. I want anybody and everybody here in CCL to challenge me for the championship. It doesn't matter if it's on an adrenaline, I don't care if it's on a pulse, I don't care if it's at a house show. I want more challenges. I want more people to challenge me. Anybody who wants a shot at the world title, they will go for it. They will not sit in the mid-card begging for an up in the national title rankings. They'll come after me. If they want to go from being a jobber to a main eventer, they'll come after me. The bottom line is, if you want a world title shot, don't even bother going to the office. You come through me. And that's all I have to say about that.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, me too.
I wonder what Mitch is getting at it.
I have no idea.
Well, yeah, of course I said it, because corporate dumbasses like you just want five people in the main event and not let everybody get a chance at the World Heavyweight Championship.
That's true. Trending worldwide right now, corporate jack, corporate dumbasses.
Exactly right. I'm glad to see you remembered it. Because I'm about to make you live up to your word, Mr. Black.
What is he getting at?
You see, starting tonight, everywhere you go in CCL, whether it's on Adrenaline, or Pulse, or at a house show, or at a pay-per-view event, every single match you are in, whether it's a singles match, triple threat, four-way, five-way, six-way, battle royal, bunkhouse stampede, whatever, every time you're in a match that's not a tag team match, your CCL World Heavyweight Championship is going to be on the line. Because as God, as my witness, you will never be my world champion! Never!
Oh, well, now it's out.
Well, no shit. The day that I become your world heavyweight champion will be the day that I get fat off the bacon that comes from the pigs that flew out of my ass.
So what, like every match he's in now is a title match?
Apparently.
No. You see, Greg, you're here on my time, and you're in my ring, so I'm the one making all the rules here. I'm not going to come down there because that's what you want me to do. No, I'm staying up here on this stage here because I want to watch the destruction of Gregory Black against the man you'll be facing tonight.
I guess who's that?
There.
You better look out!
Wow. I can't believe that's a problem.
Sadly, I'm beginning to believe it's not going to come. can rework for you. Don't let the boss mad at you.
Greg, tonight your world title will be on the line against the big rig, Mark Austin. Have holy fun, crap. You two.
I'm as serious as a heart attack is here.
Big Rig touches back on world champion from behind. Look at this thing going to be in going into that match. Look at this thing being in after the match you had at Supernova.
You can't be hurt now.
That's a CCS. That thing is beautiful.
Yeah, like a cat that ate the canary.
Well, apparently, I guess they want this man to be the face of the company. What kind of bullshit is this?
I have no idea.
We are back. This is CCL Adrenaline, and who's the boss talking to now?
Yeah, shudder to think.
He's already had a good night. Him and his douchebag general manager just set Black up failure by putting him in a match against Big Rig after he got attacked.
We might need that ambulance before this match is over with.
What the fuck are you talking to?
I would like to know that! Well, first run through all the contests, here's the first level.
This is scheduled 4-1 ball. Here's your big man.
Here does come the hooligan.
Oh,
I'm still from that announcement that the boss just made. Mike, look at that every time.
And he tries to correct the fourth after hooligan Lewis Murphy. Chris Edwards is a ring announcer.
Apologize for that. I'm sorry. I'm kind of discombobulated from the boss just said. But every time he wrestles now, it's going to be for the title.
Gregory Black got a pretty good job after he won the title back in April. And then he won a challenge. He won a competition. Looks like that best one is going to kill him.
Look, I'm pretty sure it doesn't matter. Well, he had a fighting champion and wanted to take one on Thomas, but I'm pretty sure when he said he did not mean it to come like take on a dismiss. Him to challenge.
That's very true.
Him to challenge in every match that he had, it seems like.
Stepping into the realm of the deadly, sinister vampire warrior. I'ma bust that buster, crush that hustler. Sock all you suckers, leave you flunks in a fluster. Punch till you buster, crunch till you crushed up. Rock with the ruckus, leave you mashed up, you muster. Lost your mind, now you hanging and clanging for your life. When I strike, I be mangling and strangling with a bite so precise. No man could be handling the vampire warrior who's fanging and
it's the Butcher. 45
pounds.
The Butcher and overkill. And he's got the color difference.
Who got the chainsaw?
I don't know. What me?
Did you really tell this man he can't bring the chainsaw anywhere? Really?
Oh. You know, we're pretty close to Halloween, and I bet you can look at his weather face with that thing. Someone just did.
Like, Hodgkin or something, good lord. I mean, I don't know how we're supposed to deal with loss of limb, I'm just saying.
Exactly. I mean, I don't think our insurance deposit covers that kind of grievous injury.
There's a clothesline by the Butcher. Oh my god!
Big back body drop. And before we go any further, folks, I'd like to point out, not to cut anyone off here, but you'll notice the ring ropes and part of the ring apron is pink this month. In case you didn't know, CCL is going pink in honor of Breast Cancer Awareness Month. And for more information, you can go to Komen.org for the Susan G. Komen Breast Cancer Foundation. Whichever charity you wish to support, support it, because cancer is a menace and we need to get rid of it, in my opinion.
Cancer sucks.
Yeah. Right. As my, to quote my friend Joe Van Ginkle, screw cancer.
I'll add to that and say, fuck cancer.
There you go.
There, fuck cancer. Yeah. Look at these two guys. Like, I kind of figured when this match was made, it was going to be one of those bowling shoe ugly matches where it wasn't going to be catch as catch can. They were going to beat the shit out of each other.
Yeah, this is just an old-fashioned fight, ladies and gentlemen. This ain't a wrestling match. It's just a fight.
Yeah, if you go to Lewis Murphy, that's all he does is fight.
Exactly.
And if you can't lose, if you must, but always fight, that is the mantra. Oh, one Lewis Murphy, that's a well blown.
Yeah, he'll be singing Soprano in the shower after that one.
This is probably what Murphy's going to have to do here. Keep the big man down.
Yeah.
Because if he's mobile, he can hurt you. Lewis Murphy, Irish whip. Oh, what a tilt-a-whirl sidewalk slam.
It just pushed him down.
Right.
soon as right here, as soon as the rest of legs.
Oh, and out he goes.
Head drop to the floor of the Metro Center.
This crowd here in Canada's loving the
eye. Oh, there's the mist!
Mist in the eye! And the link for rejection!
No call from the governor to stop that one.
Mist in the eye and a thumb in the neck.
Covers him. That's all she wrote.
I'll do it. Don't you make it look easy, didn't you?
Booker just waded through him like that.
Excuse me.
What the hell? Good Lord, really?
Again?
We just heard from him.
He's probably going to come out of Moana's mapping.
I wouldn't go that far, but you got a good evening once again, ladies and gentlemen of Halifax, Nova Scotia. I thank you. Now, at our next mega event, Black Friday, the World Heavyweight Championship will be on the line. Gregory Black, assuming, of course, he is still the champion. Well, he will defend his championship that night in Seattle. But who exactly will he face? We will leave that to the superstars of the CCL to decide. Starting tonight and over the next few weeks, there will be a single elimination tournament to determine a new number one contender. The last man standing will face the CCL World Heavyweight Champion, whomever he may be, at Black Friday on Friday, December the 20th. As for that one missing spot in the bracket you see there, that will be filled on the next edition of Pulse. There will be a six-man over-the-top rope battle royale to determine who is worthy of that final spot. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, let the tournament begin!
I think the only way you could win was by submission.
Right. Absolutely true. We've got ourselves an interesting situation here.
The number one contender is the first match in the tournament to determine who will be the new number one contender for the War in which I won. Nice first element in the house.
But something we got to also consider here, gentlemen. Mr. did say, if Black was the champion by Black Friday, not only does he have to deal with the fact that every time he stands going forward is a championship match, he still has an empty arena match with Joseph Vato on the Adrenaline before Black Friday.
On the Adrenaline season finale that's coming up in about 6 weeks' time. Top of my head.
Right now, Michael Heineman, he's laying the leather in early, but Nathan House, he's matching him move for move.
Winner of this match will face either CJ Logan or the winner of the Over the Top Rope Battle Royal that will take place on the next episode of Pulse. Nice rock told there by House. Both of these men former World Heavyweight Champions.
Heineman had a pretty good reign as the world champion until he lost it in 2011 at Future Shock after Tommy Caprae cashed in his Money in the Bank marker.
Oh, my God.
Jesus.
Sunset powerbomb on the floor.
And that's concrete, ladies and gentlemen. There ain't no fucking mask. That's concrete.
Yeah, well, it's only respect organizations that use masks as their prerogative and so forth and so on. We just don't use them.
Exactly. That's old school, baby. That goes back to the 70s and 80s. You'd go right on the floor. And now Nathan House going to try to cover him. Gets one, gets two, and that's about all he's going to get.
In addition, the new women's champion, Pyra, will be in action tonight. So we will have one champion being in action tonight. The tag champs are also in action tonight. Future Foundation to
and
take
oh, oh, again!
Oh, my God, again!
You could hear his head smacking off of that ground. It was like a shotgun going off. Oh!
And I'm returning the favor from earlier, sending House to the steps.
Talk about Pyra. You talked, we'll talk about her a little bit. She, if you're watching the event that we had recently, Supernova, she won the women's championship single-handedly in a six-way match. She eliminated all five competitors by herself.
That was the most dominating freaking performance I've ever seen in my life.
Absolutely true.
I'm throwing clothesline by House, and I said I'm in position right
here. You gotta be aware of your position at all times in professional wrestling. Leapfrog by Hyman, another leapfrog by Hyman. Oh, went for a...
Wait a minute!
Strike one!
And Hyman has also my... I'm a reason, but... Throws it down two and...
Almost gets a three count, but...
On the legs of House. Both have the same height, 6'9". Both way about the same, as a matter of fact. And I'm with a standing figure four.
You look at that. It's almost like a modified figure four and sort of cross with a sharpshooter.
I mean, very, very proficient when it comes to submission. And that's why one of his monikers for his career was Fat for Snatch.
Whoa!
Damn.
Well, that's a bit unexpected. I'm channeling his inner lucha stuff there. House was inside of it. Oh, House rushed in and Hyman caught him with a suplex neckbreaker. His final semifinals on the line here. Hooks the leg and gets an earful.
Very close. Under the ropes, he comes out. Oh, a Luthes press.
Right hands, my house.
That was the biggest collision you used to get in the NFL. You know, we're in the football season almost.
Right.
By the way, how's your fantasy teams going?
I don't want to talk about that.
I'm surprised Eddie still talked to me after the ass that I put on her. You're welcome, by the way.
Oh, a huge elbow.
That was a big fucking elbow by House. I think he's setting them up for the finish here.
Looking to flip this house, if you will.
Been a while.
Got a hook on Hyman.
Crossface.
Crossface.
That big foot position. Nine, that 6'9" frame helping out there.
The advantage of being 6'9". In a corner. In a bulldog.
I think he might be setting him up and put him in a position to snap or tap. Nope.
Oh, and a gut wrench two play there by Nathan House.
Oh, look at that! I'm with the rock bottom!
Right.
Didn't go for a cover. That's a mistake. Any backflip to death. I'm going for a cover. That's me. No kick there. CJ Adesanya and Logan are the winner of the Battle Royal will waste the winner in the semifinals. Battle Royal will take place next week on Pulse. And Hyman's got paper measurement.
Oh.
To win.
That was a La Magistral cradle. I'm very impressed. Now, Michael Hyman, he's putting the boot in. Oh!
First thing you don't care.
Exactly. And, oh!
Oh!
A brain buster!
This is brain buster there. Nope. Hyman.
Nope.
Win a miss.
Strike two!
Yeah,
like good and breakfast there with a strike too. World Series getting ready to start too.
Exactly right.
Actually, World Series, I believe that. Yeah.
Yeah, starts this coming Wednesday. We'll be seeing Lewis versus Boston, I believe.
Now, a rematch of the 2004 World Series.
Yep. I believe Boston won that series. It wasn't St. Louis.
Your games?
St. Louis or Boston? Oh, man.
Now, I think I was going for a heck of a, but this was so close to end up being a splash. But what happens? It's still effective, right?
Man. A little triple suplex though. A triple German.
Those are very effective.
Yeah, he was channeling his inner Ben Wall on that one.
Behind him, but house back up.
And oh, a power box.
He's a house of fire.
Oh,
my sir.
I just thought of something.
What's that?
I've been going to the outside again. Yeah, they say he's smart, brains, and so forth and so on. I just thought of something. One of the very first matches you fought was the 40-man Money in the Bank Royal Rumble champ, and the last two in that match were the... Oh, look out!
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, you're right. They were the last two.
Goodness.
I believe Halifax is the one that got the victory. So Hyman is trying to not repeat that. That happened.
Is everybody okay?
Listen.
Testing. One, two, three. Testing.
I can't hear me.
Can you hear me?
We hear you. I did not expect that. We're not even 40 minutes in this show and the table's already been broken. What the hell?
I want hazard pay.
Oh, what a catch.
Of the best, Hyman.
Back to the
headbreaker. Oh, my goodness.
Well,
I thought Hyman was
going to
set up to the
flip this
house
on
the table, but
house
stayed alive.
That was about as good a catch as any catch that Megatron's ever had in his career.
All right.
Hey, it's that grip. Ready, setting him up.
Oh, break the eye bind.
Now,
here it is.
Look at him. I'm trying to submission here.
You blew before him if somebody tap out.
He just might do it too. He gets
and
it.
And he does.
Wow.
He's in the house tap and Hyman's moving on.
That is correct. Time of the fall, 11 minutes and 21 seconds.
Definitely a back and forth matchup between these two juggernauts, two former world champions. Look at that. They've gone to a neck breaker. And then right here, I thought it was a turning point. They're sitting here minding their own damn business.
I thought he was going to do it on the floor.
Like I said, I thought that was a turning point right there. I thought it was over behind him. Whipped this out to the tables. Done. But it was not. I haven't kept fighting.
House of the Spine Buster. Have been in position to put it away, perhaps look, I think he might have been looking at the people's elbow, don't quote me on that.
Well, I think he was too after the Spine Buster, but he fell asleep a little bit, and even if a little bit, there's another for Mike behind him to do this.
Got that arm and head submission. He's gonna pull an arm out of his socket. And
I'm sure there's a name that.
Maybe we'll get an
answer.
You're not the hardcore champion. Take the gold off.
What the hell? Damn hardcore champion, stop that. Your bottom delusional as a regular Cowboys fan.
As much delusional as Joseph Matos.
Well, Matos is a different kind of delusional.
Wait a minute. This is
what?
I think this is footage from what happened after the match was over. You know, now that I think
No, it wasn't after the match. It was earlier today before we went on the air.
That's what I mean. Told him my air. This apparently happened before the show.
Yeah, it's true. You know, I out there with you. I heard there was a lot of commotion happening in the back when we got in the arena this afternoon. Of course, I just thought maybe they were just in the loading dock.
I guess good thing cameras were rolling, I guess.
Our camera team people, you know, they don't miss much.
This is basically an assault.
And he is throwing him around like a sack of potatoes.
It's better that he lost the hardcore title in that ladder match. It's better that he got the title taken away from him.
I mean, the problem is that if y'all didn't see Supernova, what happened was Hyman went into that match as the hardcore champion, but David Mitchell, one of the few things he's done right since he's been general manager was he held the title up vacant because Hyman won the match, but not by the rules that were structured for that match, which is Hooligan rules. He won by submission. Jesus.
And then, you know, they held it up, and Suicido won it back in that match. Oh, good lord.
Oh, my God. Did you see that?
People threw the fucking water thing at him.
What a good lord.
And those are 5 pound, those are 5 gallon bottles, and a gallon weighs 8 pounds. That's a 40 pound weight he threw at him.
Yeah, man, so instead of fucking with Gregory Black, why don't you come out and do something about this asshole?
Speaking of champions, we're going to have a world title match tonight. The current world heavyweight champion, Gregory Black, will defend the 10 pounds of gold against a big rig, Mark Austin, in what should be a barn burner.
And if Danny Mitchell has his way, this will be the last thing for Gregory Black as a world heavyweight champion.